Then my next question for you guys would be, I guess we kind of addressed it a bit, but I want to talk in more details. Is there going to be a new type of social media in the future that's specifically created for the Web3 users? And if there will be, like, what type of or what kind would you envision that to be?
I think the thing, I mean, I'll just kind of somewhat repeat, but I think the thing I'm excited about are like, there's a lot of problems in the world which are worthy of our attention. There's a lot of interesting questions in the world which are worthy of people, you know, whether it's academics or whoever working on. There's a lot of creative people in the world who have a lot of creative skills and would love to find meaning through contributing their work. The thing that's tricky is there's a lot of barriers for, you know, the world isn't meritocratic. Like the amount of work or how good your work is doesn't always guarantee that you're going to connect with the people and get valued for your work. So I think the web in general has obviously lifted that democratic creation and connection through Reddit, through Facebook, through whatever. But I think there's this whole other kind of vision of where it could go, where we're seeing it already, where it's like NFT music, you know, where it's like you can own and share music, and the people that listen to it first can have some ownership or stake in it or some kind of ownership in it. So I think that like when we talk about the future of like social media, social networks, I think it'll become more localized and more niche around like music collection, around organizing to like whether it's like fix a pothole in your town or whether it's like get somebody to fundraise as like a senator or I don't know, just to like throw a pizza party. I don't know. I think that there's like a lot of interesting ways to coordinate and like communicate with people that won't just be like just content based. I think I'll go beyond content and into like our actual lives more. It's my best guess.
One thing that might be I don't think that we're gonna have like a Twitter on the blockchain as be like the runaway hit for crypto social media. One thing that could be interesting is like if we look at social media today as being like small 140 character things, we could have like bigger projects. So one of the things that crypto, like Wikipedia style things. So one of the things that crypto is really good at is figuring out like the coordination problem because like protocols have well-defined like coordination mechanisms for people to engage with and for people to be incentivized with. So maybe we'll see like bigger projects like a new style, a new Wikipedia or people making an entire film or like basically like instead of it being one person contributing many things, maybe we'll have many people contributing to one giant thing. Whether that be an in-person project, like a building a like art project, or building a there's this new concept by Balaji around the network state. So maybe there'll be multiple people contributing in to a country, or sort of just like it's just like multiple people coordinating on one thing as opposed to or I mean. Or of course, then like there's the digital thing. What's like the Wikipedia? That's what the trench. That should be from like IRL to like digital. And so I think we'll see many people contributing to one thing, or maybe it'll be like curated sets. So you have multiple people contributing to a curated database, and it's not just one person who has control of it.
I think both of you guys have brought up very, very good point. And you also talk about people contributing to one thing or one person contributing to different thing. That's all leads to the point that the social media or social network will not only influence the social part of people's life, but also like functional part, your daily lives, your job, not only the entertainment part, your education, and even more.
So like education could be like one of those things that is like the blowaway hit for social media in the sense that like people are incentivized to learn. Maybe there's like a company that's paying someone to learn around. Maybe it's like SpaceX needs someone who's like an expert welder and like welding just isn't taught anymore in schools, or they need someone who knows like a very specific propulsion thing and like that's just not taught. So they pay people to learn that mechanism, then they can hire those people. But I think education and social networks could be like one of those like probably things that if it works, it would be huge.
Yeah. Chris, do you have anything you want to add on to that point?
No, I mean, I guess the thing that I take away from all this is, like, anyone listening, to me, Web3 is going to be bigger than whatever we're calling Web3 right now. Probably won't even use that phrase in a few years. So this is like really early days. And
Web5.
I think, yeah.
I'm just joking.
Yeah. So I think there's like a great opportunity to just get involved. And whether that's like learning to code or learning to whatever skill, like design, manage, make music. I think there's like so many opportunities. So just need like curious people, because it goes well beyond, you know, NFTs or this kind of where we're at right now. We're in like day zero. And I think that there's like a lot of opportunity. If you start right now, you know, in five years, you're going to be like an expert for sure.
I agree.